Amongst all the antioxidants in the world, astaxanthin is one which has two critical properties. So I tend to perceive astaxanthin as a bifocal antioxidant. It acts on the lipid cell wall, giving it structural integrity, and it acts on the mitochondria, giving it functional integrity. So because of its bifocal action, it has a fantastic antioxidant effect on all these cells across all the systems. If you look at antioxidants, you'll suddenly realize that antioxidants are supposed to have properties which vary between the antioxidants. Some are liposoluble, some are hydrosoluble. And the most important thing is you need to look at antioxidants from a completely different perspective. And that perspective is, does it have any anti-inflammatory property? And the fact is, astaxanthin not only is a fantastic antioxidant, it also has anti-inflammatory property. Therefore, it's a two-in-one property that makes astaxanthin stand out. All my life I used to believe that coenzyme Q10 is one of the greatest gifts to mankind till I started working on astaxanthin. The more I read about it, the more I was shocked to see how ignorant I was. But better late than never. So here I am, enlightened to realize the potential of astaxanthin. See, as far as diseases of the brain are concerned, there are two particular aspects which concern me. One is called neurodegeneration, and the other is conditions which affect children, which is called as ADHD. To date, the only known nutraceutical which is used for ADHD is omega-3. I find a great future ahead for a combination of omega-3 plus astaxanthin in ADHD children. And as far as neurodegeneration is concerned, astaxanthin is a superb antioxidant because it crosses the blood-brain barrier without any hurdles. And that is one of the things which is going to shape the efficacy of this product in this particular condition.